Good evening.
Good
planet Earth.
Evening.
Welcome mortals. To Star Fox Beer Bros.
What's up, guys?
What's up?
So, Jirard's the only person on the entire internet who like.
I love this game. It's got its flaws, but I love it.
Does it have flaws?
It does.
What are the flaws?
Controls are not the cleanest.
Are they not clean, or is it just have like a really high?
Like it's learning
both.
Curve.
It's both.
Okay. So I think what we're gonna do here is I know a lot of people haven't been able to see this game because they
don't have a Wii U or don't want
to
play it.
I think most people are just unwilling to try something that somebody else says is bad.
Yeah, that's true.
And I think that what our goal is gonna be here is to show you that this game is actually freaking sick. It's actually like super
fun as hell. I know that SEO wise and importance wise this game is kind of already gone, but I don't care.
No, it's tight. We're gonna do great. This is a perfect game for us to play. Like
it's our roots.
Yeah, we got a lot to learn. I'm gonna try and do trivia a little bit.
Now I'm not gonna play a fresh file because I don't want to delete all my hard work.
Right.
So I'm just gonna play every stage until the end. That's the goal.
We're just gonna beat this game, and then.
Spoiler alert, this is how the completion screen looks when you beat the game. Complete it.
Depending on... complete it. Depending on how long it takes, we're going to try and beat every level in the game.
We're going to try to beat it.
But that's only what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 levels, something like that?
Something like that, yeah.
Yeah.
So, Alex, we're going to start off with the old classic, Corneria.
Classic. Good old Corneria. So... the whole deal with Star Fox Zero is that it's like not quite a reboot. Does that make sense? Like, it's similar to the way that Link Between Worlds.
Star Fox, do you read me? We're under attack from Andross's army.
So that's coming out of Jirard's gamepad.
We'll take the job. Andross won't be getting his way this time.
God, he looks so scary with those teeth. I played a bunch of this game when it first came out. Nintendo sent me a copy.
I forgot that the audio doesn't come out of the TV, comes out of the gamepad.
Yeah, so can we make it so that that's not the case?
No.
Are you sure?
Pretty sure. Entering. Sorry, I skipped the tutorial.
It's okay, we'll beat it. Wow, it looks great.
Try not to talk too much.
Yeah, we play Beard Bros on a really big TV. So, this looks really stunning to me right now. Wow. Okay, so Star Fox Zero was kind of envisioned as like a... almost like a retelling more than it is a reboot. Because I don't think it's like impacting the lore. And I don't know if it actually takes place at the same time or if it's like a Zelda situation where it's just like... you know, both are true and it just like doesn't really make sense. But that's kind of like how Nintendo does lore. And I kind of like that because it kind of just... helps you focus on the gameplay a little bit better, which is what you should be doing in Star Fox. This game was co-developed by Platinum Games. After a little bit, they came in and tried to clean up the mechanics a little bit. Because admittedly, the mechanics are complicated, but I think that the true gold of this game comes from spending time learning how to play it. You know what I mean? And for people who don't know, like, I don't know if I'm the best person to try, but like, maybe you can help explain to people like how the controls are weird for this game.
So a big thing for this game and why the controls are weird. I'm gonna turn the audio down just a little bit.
Yeah.
The big thing of why the controls are weird is that you use both the gamepad, like bottom screen to like aim specifically, and you fly at the same time.
Yeah,
a lot of people are struggling with it, but you'll notice, Alex, they can't see me. But I'm rarely staring at the gamepad.
Yeah, it's like kind of like Splatoon. Like, I don't know if you guys... I know a lot of people who played Splatoon were like, oh, this is so freaking casual. Like, I need to turn off the move to look right away. But it's similar. It feels really similar in terms of, like, how it feels to aim. And the intention is that you look at the TV most of the time, and then you almost use your gamepad to, like... ADS, like you would in a shooter, if that makes sense. Like,
yeah, your gamepad is more or less your more focused screen. We're gonna go ahead and do the normal route this round. Usually we can take the secret route to the right if we step on the switch. Also new to this game, which I'm sure many of you know of, is that at any given second, I can turn into this bad boy, the raptor.
Little raptor man.
If you touch water, he will turn back into the regular plane.
Because he can't walk on water.
Cannot walk on water.
He's not Jesus Christ. He's just a raptor.
Nah, he's just a raptor, man.
Nah, dude, just a raptor.
I know Jesus Christ had treads and shit, but raptors don't.
Yeah,
so,
I ain't got
know.
None, but I plan on throwing some.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. You know where it's at.
Yep.
Now, with the laser, too, you get multi-function targeting when you have a full upgraded laser, which I like a lot. So you can shoot up to two things at once. It's real tight.
Yeah, this is great. I mean, look how good it looks.
I think it looks great.
Is that a thing people have been saying, is that it doesn't look good?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
What's wrong with it?
I don't know. I think
like,
it's
what
great.
Are the, what are the complaints? I think it looks freaking beautiful.
So right now, here's one of my first complaints, is that I can't actually... Like, sometimes during these cutscenes, you lose control of Fox, and you get into this weird 360 mode where you have no choice but to use...
The gamepad.
And that's kind of a bummer.
It's a thing that, like, really takes effort to get good at. But I think that the mechanics are solid.
Yeah, I mean...
Like,
you know,
every once in a while I was playing this, like, I definitely had trouble with it. I'm not, like, saying I didn't. But, like, every once in a while, I'd, like, get into the zone where I would just become, like, totally lethal. And just, like, really, like, use the features to my... Like, to their full extent of their power. And it's just tight. Like, I don't know. Like, it's cool. Like, so we're in Corneria. And I'm gonna try and give a little bit of trivia to you guys. And some of this you might have remembered from when we did Star Fox 64, because a lot of the levels are the same. But apparently the currency of Corneria and the Lylat system in general uses the same denomination as American U.S. dollars. So I don't know if that means anything. I don't know if that has, like, anything to do with the lore or something weird like that. I doubt it does. But that's a thing to keep in mind. Especially now that Star Fox has kind of a lot more overtly added extra dimensions to the story. Like, alternate dimensions. They kind of, like, made that much more part of the story. And I think that it was, like, Nintendo sort of, like, acknowledging the lore that the fans had kind of created based on their secret levels and whatnot. And a lot of the stuff from the Nintendo Power comic about Star Fox. About, like, James McCloud, like, sealing Andross away in, like, another dimension and, like, having to die. Because, like, Andross, like, rigged his Arwing to, like, blow him up or something.
To detonate, yeah.
Yeah, and so now it's kind of like put James McCloud in this weird, like, is he or isn't he kind of situation. Does that make sense? I don't really know exactly, like...
Sorry, I'm not paying attention right now. I'm kind of letting this end when I need to be more focused.
What?
I'm just, like, not really paying attention right now.
To what?
To the my life or ways of life in this.
You're playing. You're killing the dudes. You're bopping the boys.
That's phase two done. Could be better, but that's okay.
That was
okay.
Pretty good. I mean, like, you only missed it by six.
On my old score?
Yeah.
Yeah, so check this out. One of my favorite things about Star Fox Zero is that as you've kind of, like, garnered... I should have kept that so you guys could see it. This is the boss. Now, this is where the forced perspective comes into play, right? Like, all I can see is this in front of me.
Yeah, and you still fly. You still have
to
look
at... Yeah, we'll give you an idea, though. This is what it looks like. This is what's on the gamepad.
Yeah.
So, I know it's going to be weird for you guys, but I've gotten so used to it at this point that I can make it work.
Like, playing on the gamepad?
I can play just like this right now as we're doing it.
Dude, that's...
So check it out. We're just going to go ahead and sneak into this bad boy. Going to turn into the raptor. Running inside. Open the door, please. And we're going to beat this boss.
Like,
no, and just in case.
Easy mode, boys. So you can just bop this boss like this?
Yep.
It's like a little secret way to bop the boss?
Yep.
Damn.
It's actually, this is with the second... this is a secret way. And we're done.
That's so
tight. So the traditional way of beating this boss is you have to take out all the satellites on top. And then when you do that, you win. Or an alternate way, and that's actually how you get a badge, is you take out the satellites on top, at least half of them, and then go inside and defeat the boss that way.
Damn. So that's the other thing about this.
Mission accomplished means that you did the special route to get the special ending.
So that's the other thing about this playthrough that's going to be kind of cool is, like, I know a lot of people didn't spend a lot of time on this game. and Jirard knows this game better than probably anyone alive, so we're going to learn a little bit about some of the level secrets and some little neat things like this.
Yeah.
So that's pretty exciting.
Yeah.
Also, did you know that it's possible that Corneria could come from, possibly come from the fact that it's in the corner on the map? Isn't that weird?
So, as you can tell, I've only beaten the score that's in gray, that's in the middle. That's the game score.
That's the goal. That's the one you have to beat to get gold.
Right, and my score is the one on top. 301 is my highest score.
You beat it by one.
Beat it by one.
Pretty crazy. I mean, it's pretty hard to get medals in this game.
It's a lot harder than in Star Fox 64, that's for sure.
Yeah. You really have to, get good. And can you do it in co-op mode?
Oh, absolutely. Co-op mode in this game is great.
Yeah, maybe we'll show that off in the bonus episode.
So what I want to do now is I want to replay Corneria.
Okay.
You're
going to show him the secret
way? I'm going to show him the secret way.
Great, let's do it.
And the reason why is because, similarly to how we did our Beard Bros playthrough for Star Wars 64, instead of doing multiple playthroughs, we're going to be doing each level
in succession. Yeah, now that we can do it, because we can just pick levels in this game.
Select is huge in this one. Yeah, before it was an on-the-rail experience. You just start your run over and over kind of stuff. Yeah,
which is great for an old game, but for this, it's much more important that we be able to, choose and pick. And
I wonder if I can fix the sound. 3D voice, will that do it?
I'm not sure. You might be able to do it in the options menu. We'll try and do it between this episode and the next one if we can.
I'm pretty sure you can't do it. Although I've seen footage of it though.
Yeah.
But maybe I'm wrong.
Maybe they just captured the audio from the gamepad.
No, I've done that. It's not very good.
You can do it with a cable, but it's just sounds kind of weird.
Yeah, I'll try fixing it after this run.
I love the enemy designs in this game. Look how cool that thing is.
It's very much the similar feel of Star Fox 64.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of the enemies are straight out of Star Fox 64, but there's a lot of new enemies that...
This is one of my favorite things to do right here. Is to just,
Bob.
Chill. Bob and weave. Okay, keep this going infinitely. It's a tight way to, get some more enemies.
Hell yeah.
Go ahead and do this.
Man, this game is so intricate, I think a lot of people miss that about it.
Yeah.
I think people were expect that's the thing that makes me sad all the time, is that people kind of that's nothing to do with, I know this is one of those games that people like to say, you suck at the game, so you reviewed it poorly. You know?
But I'm not throwing any shade, but there definitely is a review site out there that did a horrible job as reviewing it.
Right, but you know what? That aside, I think it's... I don't think it's about whether or not you suck at the game. I think it has more to do with... if you're a critic, it's your responsibility to not let your expectations, impact your... you have to take it for what it is when you're going to criticize something.
Right.
I think if you're not going to do that, stop complaining about Ghostbusters.
Roasted.
Come at me.
No, I don't want to come at you, dude. I just that's the thing that people forget that I love about games and why I don't take reviews wholeheartedly is that I fucking love games.
Yeah.
In 2016, we have so many rad games out there. To sit here and be this game sucks, this game sucks, this game sucks. It's
truly, you really think this game sucks? Clearly, extremely polished, beautiful, logically designed game. You think it sucks?
So check it out. Secret route.
Yeah.
We get a badge for doing so. Now in this case, we have to help feed off the ship from all the enemies, or you can throw a bomb and save it.
Saved us.
Now when you do that, we're going to go ahead and open up a special portal.
What's that?
It appears to be a teleporter.
How sick is this?
Our meeting suggests enemy activity on the other side.
Like the one at the colony, huh? Better check it out. I'm going in.
So the portals are now a big part of the story of this game.
Yeah.
And I love that. I love that, there's, alternate dimensions.
This boss fight, kid you not, I suffered for 3 hours on. Because I didn't quite understand what was going on, how hard it was. But what I will show to you now is that I can wreck this boss so nicely.
Right.
If I remember.
This is such a tight thing.
So the boss from the first level came back from the future, kind of.
It's like an alternate version of the boss, basically.
Yeah, okay, so this boss is actually tough for a few reasons. First and foremost, we've got this little bay. The
to me, Lucina is bay.
The little blue explosion. Now, if I'm not out of here before it goes off again, I'm in trouble.
The, like,
so we
want to
try and do as much damage as we can and then get the fuck out.
Yeah, you did pretty good. Yeah, that blue shit hurts, brother.
Yeah, it's real bad.
Ooh, you can hit it.
No, I'm good.
Oh, you got it. Wow.
Now we're going back in.
Satellite boys.
I'm getting wrecked real bad right now, but mostly because I'm trying to do as much damage as I can before that happens.
Well, you got out.
I did. Now, we're actually okay, because now the ship's going to rise from the water. We're just going to go ahead and...
Keep on keeping.
Tight.
Get out.
No, I'm probably going to die right now.
Get out.
Oh, I'm not dead yet, but I did kill...
Only two more.
Yeah.
You can probably snipe him from, like, fairly far away, right?
I can, yes. The issue is that... Now that this is happening...
Can you shoot lasers through it?
Yes, I can.
Yeah, so now he's going to jam in, pop this
dude. No, we're going to probably get away from... I'm not going to be able to keep to do it.
I love these complicated bosses. I love that. Because it teaches you... It's basically like a lesson on how to speedrun.
Kind of, yeah. You'll notice, too, that I missed the timer so far. But that's okay, because I've already beaten this game.
There she blows, boys.
I missed it entirely.
It's all good.
And we're done.
Clean, boys. That's so tight. I love the imagination that all these games always have. Nintendo has the biggest imagination of any first-party developer.
So, I mean, yeah, I didn't do it that well, but you know what? Like, I'm pretty good, considering.
Also, Mighty No. 9, take note. That's how you do fire effects.
So, the target time, I believe, is 2 minutes and 15 seconds, but I've crushed it so many times that it's just... My best time is 1 minute 16.
Yeah. Damn. We should have done this right after you completed it so you could be, like, a fucking ace.
You know what? We should have. I should have just been like, hey, haters, what's up?
Yeah, but you know what? Fuck it. Now you haters get a lesson on how cool this game is, and there's not as much hate going on about the game anymore.
I'm going to try and fix the audio. I didn't try to do it from the options.
Yeah.
Maybe I can. Oh, yeah, there isn't one. There isn't one, I recall.
There's no options menu in this game?
No. Aside from what's like in the main menu.
If you go to the sound test, you can't do anything about it?
No. It's just, you get... The sound test is something you unlock as well.
Wow.
Yeah, it's just a sound test.
Well, I'm sure we'll find out if there's a way to do it. In the comments.
I'm pretty sure there isn't, but...
Right. Okay.
So we'll try and shift. So we're still pretty early on in this playthrough. We can probably do one more level.
Yeah, let's rock through
one more. Let's do a Sector Alpha.
Frenzied
Firefight. Boys.
This is good. This is feeling like... This feels like an old-style Beard Bros playthrough or something. Thanks to you, Star Fox. I'm feeling good. No, I'm loving it. To relax. An enemy fleet is approaching, and we need you on the front lines. I'll do my best, General. Shout out to Sergeant Pepper's Heart Club... Heart... Lonely Hearts Club Band.
Yeah, dude.
General Pepper. I guess they didn't want to get sued. I don't think that's why. I think it was just a reference, you guys. God damn, this game looks sweet. It just looks good. It looks like exactly like Star Fox 64 somehow, but also it looks like really pretty.
There's the one the internet loves.
No barrel roll.
Did they fix the barrel rolls to actually be barrel rolls in this game?
I mean, it's the same shit as before.
Jaw feel. So, Sector Alpha is the site of a battle between the two fleets, Cornarian and Andross. And apparently, you're kind of like showing up and helping them win the battle.
Yeah. This is kind of like Sector Y from Star Fox 64.
Yeah, it's like a nebula. It's cool. And this has a cool boss fight at the end that it's another one of those fights where you can, like, go in.
Yeah, absolutely. It's actually where the... You learn about that...
It's like the lesson about going in comes
exactly.
From this.
Absolutely.
Also, you can see on the ships, I don't know if you can see, Andross looks like Andross does in Star Fox 64 on all the ships. But in the end, I think he kind of ends up looking more like SNES Andross.
It's actually kind of both.
Yeah. Which I thought was cool.
I'm not aiming very well right now.
Oh my god, that guy just got bopped. Look how cool this is. Who's hating on this?
Well, I just want to... It's controls, Alex. Almost all of it is controls. And I just want to point out, Alex, you've never seen me really once look at the gamepad unless I've told you otherwise.
Right. I mean, you don't really have to look at it that much. It's like more. It's more of a thing for, like, pro play.
Right, but even at that, it's like... I'm just that good at the game.
Right. But I'm just saying, like, I don't really... I feel like the lesson is, if you get good at... If you, like, actually practice and learn how to play the game, this game is actually really great. And you gotta be okay with not, like, feeling awesome the first time you play through. Like, think about Metal Gear Solid, right?
So here's a Pigma segment right here.
Huh?
I'll show you. So there's Sick Pigma. He's coming to mess up the situation. If I lock onto him, we leave the level early and fight. So I'm going to avoid that fight, because I don't want to
fight
that.
Pigma, yeah.
I don't want to fight Pigma right now.
But we will.
Yeah.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, think about Metal Gear Solid, or think about Hitman, or a game that's like all about being perfect. You know what I mean? It feels sweet to play Metal Gear Solid and be excellent at it and get big boss rating. And it feels shitty to like, and like have to like run away and like kill dudes and stuff. But like... That's how it works. That's how the gameplay loop works. You learn how to get better at the game. You know, it's like Dark Souls. For reals, though. like it actually is. Like, you just die a shitload of times in Dark Souls until you get good, and then you beat the boss, and you learn how to do it. You have to... Same thing with this. You know? Nintendo's always innovating. You know, they don't... They're like, you know, controls? Fuck, we'll redesign how controls work on flight games. And I promise that if you get good at it, it actually does feel pretty damn cool.
Like I said, I love this game. I don't know why everyone hated on it. I get why, but like...
I get why. I do. But I just... I think it's shitty to be impatient. I love that the monkeys in this game are all like... Saturday morning 90s cartoon villains. It's so good. They all look so weird too. None of them wear the same clothes.
That's what I love doing in this room. Is like, this is like supposed to be the Raptor room. You can just like
fly around
like,
here. I'm
gonna
like
fucking
rock.
Kill everyone and not give a shit.
Oh.
Now for those of you guys who are looking on completing this game, fun fact, there is a badge up here. It only appears after... Sorry. It only appears after you've defeated all the enemies.
In the room,
although I think... I don't know where it is. It definitely is here. I might not have killed someone fast enough. But yeah, it definitely is in here. Oh, that's why. You still need to die.
There it is.
Boop.
So yeah, so don't look to this playthrough as a comprehensive guide to how to beat Star Fox, but like
we're gonna try to show you some tricks.
Stuff you might not see otherwise. We're working off Jirard's memory. He completed this game months ago when it came out.
It's true. So it felt like months ago.
It is months ago.
It is months ago. It felt like years ago.
Yeah,
years ago. They try to
put me in the
Yeah, I'm sure this is live.
I love the colors. It's like nice, bright colors. So pretty.
So you can sit here all day if you want. If you want to get the score and shoot everyone, you don't really get anything for doing it, but you can. Options are there.
Hell yeah.
Boop.
I don't want to mess up your day, but the Star Fox team is here.
Another secret is up here. If you're trying to get the 3 gold badge requirement, like Star Fox Zero or Star Fox 64,
you have to have it.
Yeah, there's three. I mean, I'm not gonna get that. I got it.
But can't you level up more than once in this game?
For lasers?
Yeah.
Yeah. So you don't actually. You can't actually lose your laser upgrade past the first level. So there's two laser upgrades. You get the first one, you get the second one. Second one, you can break your wings. First one, you can't. So it's always permanent. You get screen lasers and charge to one shot, and blue lasers, it's blue to shoot to two at a time.
So the blue lasers are even better in this game.
Yeah. But like what I was saying is that, you know, getting 3 gold rings will give you extra lives. In this case, in each level, or almost every level, there's 3 badges. Embedded in them.
Yeah, they're like little metal boys.
Exactly. So this is a repeat of that boss that I showed you guys earlier from the first stage. I'm just gonna go ahead and wreck him before he's done.
Like, it's basically that last one that we fought was basically like, yeah, you did it right. You did it just like this one, and now exactly. It's showing you like.
So now, if you are smart and you get the raptor, well, the raptor design. So the raptor upgrade you get in this level, and then you can go back and play other levels with the raptor stuff.
Exactly. So it's basically like. Rewarding you being like in the first level when you go back and do that, it's like, yes, you were on the right track.
Exactly.
Yeah, which is really cool. Like, that's really good game design.
And I believe mission accomplished for this stage is to defeat all the ships before they blow up the lasers or blow up the other ships.
Right.
The red ships, you mm-hmm. know, every now and then I was like, no, it's because I messed up.
So you want to go back and bop Pigma?
Yeah. So this one, I think we can actually just quick select, if I recall.
You can go and be like, I want to fight Pigma.
So obviously my best score 329.
That's crazy. Shattered that one.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not trying. If this was Star Wars 64, I get a few badges, but I'm not.
No, we're
not aiming to do that. So.
It's too much. It's too much work, and it involves a lot of repeated playing. That's the whole point.
So this right here is the.
Oh, that's Wolfen. Yeah.
This is the fight with Pigma. It's actually Pigma. It's not just Pigma. It's Pigma and Andrew.
He's the, like,
he's
my uncle is
yeah,
Andross.
Exactly. He's the nephew of Andross.
He's a butthole. Both of them are buttholes.
It's true.
Butthole is a insult that people should use more often. Shut up, Pigma, you butthole. Shut up, right. Andrew, you square glasses butthole.
Try our best to take him out. Now, this boss fight is much easier when you have lasers.
Yep. But since we started from the beginning...
We don't have lasers.
Yeah, don't
as
have
you can
them.
Tell, I am being a little wrecky.
But
now there's a cutscene happening, but I still have control of what's going on.
And you can still see on
the screen.
Pad.
So
that's tight.
And then Pigma goes down. We are
I would love
down
to find out. I would love to find out what changed when Platinum started helping develop the game. I would love to know, like, what was stuff that Miyamoto originally envisioned for the game, and what Platinum added into the mix. Because it seemed like Miyamoto was the one who was into the idea of the 2 screens, which is why we got, what's that other game called? Maybe we'll do a little bit of that in the bonus episode, too.
I've never played it, actually. It's still sealed in the box.
I've played it a bit. It's fun. It's hard. It's really stressful. It kind of feels like Five Nights at Freddy's.
Oh, man.
I mean, it's not scary like Five Nights at Freddy's, but it's like stressful like Five Nights at Freddy's. I was really impressed with that one at E3, so I was really excited to play it. So there you go. They got bopped.
So, yeah. So if I was getting the badge, I would have gotten first place for doing so.
Yeah. Dude, you did it. You beat your record.
Yeah, 114.
Hell yeah, brother.
Getting warmed up now.
Yeah, man. All right.
So this is just the first few stages of Star Fox Zero, you guys. When we get back,
Let's move on.
Probably going to move on to. We'll probably do this.
Defend the Great Fox.
No, we're gonna probably go to in canonical of the story. We'll go to Area 3.
Great.
And then we'll come back and defend the Great Fox.
Great.
And then we'll go from there.
Sick. This is cool. This is lighthearted. I like this. I'm loving this. Star Fox Zero, guys.
Yeah, dude.
Go buy this if you haven't played it and you have a Wii U. It's really
Not an ad, seriously.
Yeah, it's not worth it's not like a shitty game. It's like really worth the money if you are willing to put in the time.
You get two games for one.
Yeah, it's fun.
All right. Later,
man. Not an ad. Bye.